students, what is entity in the real world? It is anything which is distinguishable from other entities. You can consider student as an entity, whereas SCCMPN is an entity set for student. It is a class, you can say. To understand what is entity set, you can consider an example of a class in object-oriented programming language. The objects of the class are called as entities, whereas what is entity set is, it is a collection of similar type of entities stored in a same unit. So class is the best example to understand what do you mean by entity set is. Set of all person, companies, trees, holidays can be considered as entity sets. Then we have relationship set. This is, you can say, it is extra table that we create in the ER diagram or in the database, which actually help us to relate two tables, two relationships or two entity sets. So if you see this diagram, customer is one relation, whereas loan is another relation, and they are linked via these lines. So these lines will be represented by the relationship set. So customer and loan, what would be the relationship between these two? It is borrower. So this, say customer Smith borrowed a loan from bank having the loan number L11. So this way we can relate one entity set to another entity of another entity set, and entity set via the relationship set. Then the important point is, what are attributes in the ER diagram and what are different types of attributes available in ER diagram? This question may ask for 2 marks in your final exam. Define attribute and explain different types of attributes with example. So what is attribute is? It is a descriptive property of an entity set. Attribute is always descriptive property of an entity set. For student relation or student table, we can say that roll number, name, branch, phone number, etc. are the attributes of it. Then there is a concept called as domain. Domain is a set of permutable values in the attribute. So if I say roll number is the attribute having the width 2, it means that the domain for roll numbers is all the values which goes from 0 to maximum 2-digit number, that is 99. So any value which comes in between this 0 to 99 is allowed to enter into the roll number column or attribute. Okay. Then coming back to the another point, that is different types of attributes. What are different types of attributes in ER diagram? We have simple attribute versus composite attribute, single value attribute versus multi-value attribute, and then we have derived attribute. So what is simple attribute and composite attribute? Any attribute which is not divisible into multiple parts is called a simple attribute. For example, roll number, you can't divide roll number into subparts. So roll number can be considered as a simple attribute. Then what do you mean by composite attribute? Any attribute which is divisible into multiple parts, then such attribute is called as composite attribute. Let's see the example of it. Here, name can be divided into first name, middle name, and last name. So we can consider name attribute as the composite attribute. Similarly, address can also be considered as a composite attribute. We can divide the address into street, city, state, and postal code. You can further divide this street into street number, street name, and apartment name. So any attribute which is divisible into multiple part is called as composite attribute. Then the next type of attribute is single value attribute versus multi-value attribute. As the name indicates, single value attribute is an attribute which allows to enter only single value into that particular table. Means for any record, for that particular attribute, there should be only one value. There should not be more than one value for the same attribute. Such an attribute is called as single value attribute. Roll number, you can say, of a student, there is only one roll number allotted to the student. Right? Your age, there is a single value into the age column, right? Date of birth, single value. Then another type of attribute is multi-value attribute. an attribute which allows you to enter multiple values for the same record, for the same entity, then we can say that such an attribute is a multi-value attribute. For example, phone number. You can have more than one phone number. Nowadays, there are mobile phone which allows you to have more than one SIM into the same phone. So you can have two phone numbers into the same mobile. So you can have many phone numbers. Anything more than one value allowed into that attribute is called as multi-value attribute. Your email ID can also be considered as a multi-value attribute, because you can have email ID on Gmail, email ID on Outlook, or email ID on Yahoo, and so on. You can have multiple email IDs, right? In short, you can have multiple email IDs. So that's why we can consider email ID also as a multi-value attribute. Can we consider address as a multi-value attribute, students? Address of a student? Please reply in the chat box. Can we consider address of a student as a multi-value attribute? Yes, we can. Correct. You can have more than one home. You can have residence address, you can have your office address, or you can have any other address. So it can be considered as a multi-value attribute. Then coming to the next important type of attribute, it is derived attribute. What do you mean by derived attribute? It is an attribute which does not exist in the database. It is an attribute which does not exist in the database, but you can generate it. You can generate it by applying a query or writing a relational algebra expression. You can generate such an attribute is called as derived attribute. So the example of derived attribute is age of a student. Suppose consider that in the database your date of birth column is there, it is recorded, suppose, in the database. Then from that date of birth we can generate the age of the student by subtracting date of birth from the current date, today's date. We can get the age of the student very easily from date of birth. So can you tell me any other example of derived attribute? Make sure that this attribute should not be there in the database. It should be generated from the existing attribute. So please write one more example of derived attribute in the chat box. Yes, any other example of derived attribute? Yes, total marks can be calculated from marks of all the subjects. Basic salary. You can get the net salary from basic salary. Good. Percentage calculation. Excellent. Percentage calculation. Yes, percentage is the column that you can generate. Grade of student. Very good. Now we have different types of attribute, like simple attribute, then we have composite attribute, third is single value attribute, and fourth is multi value attribute, fifth is derived attribute. Now in this particular diagram, if you see, all the types of attributes are given. I will explain you how to represent simple attributes. Simple attributes are represented by simple ellipse like this. Middle name, it's a simple ellipse, so it is simple attribute. You can consider, you can say customer ID is also simple attribute. How do you represent composite attribute? Attribute divided into subpart, like name can be a composite attribute. Here in this diagram, name is divided into first name, middle name, and last name. Your address is also a composite attribute in this diagram. Multi-value attribute, how do you represent multi-value attribute? It is represented by double ellipse. Then derived attribute is represented by dotted ellipse. It is represented by dotted ellipse. Then I'm going to ask you a question. You understood what are different types of attributes. You just have to write in the chat box how to represent simple attributes, students. How do you represent simple attributes? It's a normal ellipse, correct? Yes. How do you represent multi-value attribute? Next question to you. How do you represent multi-value attributes? Excellent. It is It is double ellipse. How do you represent derived attribute? Next question, third question. Derived attribute is dotted ellipse. The answer is right. It is dotted ellipse. Now the last question. How do you represent composite attribute in ER diagram? How do you represent composite attribute in ER diagram? Ellipse with subparts. You can say ellipse with subparts. Stressing branched ellipse. It is also okay. So ellipse with subparts is called as composite attribute. Okay. All of you are right. Next one.